Mmm. Oh my gosh.
What's up everyone, I'm Chris. We got Steph behind the camera and we're hungry to travel. We are here on the island of Bali, Indonesia, a place known for its beauty, its culture, and especially its delicious local Balinese cuisine. We have a huge food tour coming up today and we're kicking it all off with the most epic Balinese food, Babi Guling. Come on, let's go. Arrive. So we're here this morning at Babi Guling Odah Sanur for one of the most iconic Balinese dishes, Babi Guling. Now this is a whole pig that's spit roasted. You can see the fire behind me here just getting going. So we are going to be seeing the whole preparation. This should be super fun. Let's see what's going on.
The first stage of the process leading to a crispy, crackling babi guling is the preparation of the pigs. They are washed and shaved to clean and sterilize. Next, they're tied onto a long spit and stuffed with a local Balinese spice mixture, unique to each warung, called bumbu ganap. They're then sewn up and rubbed with a special ketchup marinade that will turn the babi guling a beautiful red and golden brown color. The last step is to put the spit onto the wood fire, cooking the babi guling to tender perfection and creating a crunchy, brittle skin that's crisp like glass.
The pigs have just been put onto the fire behind me here, and we have actually two pigs this morning. One small pig, which takes about an hour to cook, and one medium-sized pig, which takes 2 hours. And what's cool about the cooking process here at Babi Guling Odah Sanur is that they use wood from mango and coconut trees, and they told us it's because that type of wood burns a lot hotter, so it creates a hotter fire to cook the babi guling, so it's super cool. And you can see as well, right here, that it's all done manually in the traditional way to cook babi guling. So there's no automated system. It's just one person here turning it by hand. So a lot of manual labor goes into cooking this babi guling, so traditional. Wow, you can see the pigs now are starting to turn that beautiful golden brown color. Here now in the traditional Balinese kitchen, and you can see behind me, they are preparing all of the organs for the traditional Balinese sausage. So it's nice to see that none of the animal actually goes to waste. All right, let's go check on our babi guling. Now that's what I call fall off the bone. Oh. Wow. So crispy.
So crispy.
Here we have our finished babi guling. Look at this, perfectly roasted. Oh my gosh, looks incredibly crispy and I can't wait to taste it now. Wow, so crispy. So we're here with the owner, Putu, Babi Guling Odah Sanur, and he is just kindly cut us a piece of the delicious Babi Guling skin to try first. Look at that. Look at the color of that. So hard. Thank you so much, Makasi, Putu. Okay, let's do it. Oh my gosh. Incredibly crispy. Wow. Oh, enak. Enak, oh my gosh. Just. Wow, so thin as well, but just so crispy. Amazing. Yeah, let's see him cut it some more up.
This is the best meat.
This is the best part?
Yeah.
Oh, so the best part is the leg. Oh, piping hot. You can see it steaming there. So juicy still as well. Look at that. Not dry whatsoever, and it is so hot. This is amazing. Oh my gosh, so juicy, tender, cooked to perfection. Oh, it's got a bit of a smoky flavor as well, being cooked on the wood like that. Oh my gosh.
This is the bumbu inside.
The bumbu. Yeah. Traditional bumbu spice. Balinese spices. Wow. And you can really smell the spices coming out of there. Wow. Look at that pork belly. Oh my gosh. Wow, look at this pork belly here. Oh, with the traditional bumbu. Look at that. The spices in there. Okay, let's taste the pork belly here. So tender. Oh, and the bumbu, wow. So flavorful. It's like a flavor punch to the face. Oh, that is so good.
More spicy, you can put a little bit.
Sambal?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Let's put a little sambal on there because you always have to have some sambal.
Perfect.
Oh my gosh. Spicy, but so flavorful.
Yeah, you can take it, please.
Oh wow, the cheek.
Yeah.
The cheek skin.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Look at this ultimate Babi Guling bite. So we have the nice, delicious skin, the meat, the bumbu, and some sambal on the top as well. Look how juicy this looks. Just incredible. Okay, cheers. Wow. Speechless, Putu. The meat melts in your mouth. So tender. Oh my gosh. So nice to try the legendary Babi Guling here at Babi Guling Odah Sanur. Such a traditional way of cooking it, and the taste is just out of this world. Oh, Putu. The
foot.
The foot?
Yeah.
Wow. We're getting the full Babi Guling experience here. Look at that. Got the little hoof here. Oh my gosh. Okay. Mmm. The skin is slightly still crispy, but the foot, like a pork hock, is nice and gelatinous. You can see in there. Oh, super hot. And yeah, just nice and almost jello-like taste to that. Mmm. Oh, you can see there's a little bit of meat there too. I like the hoof.
This, let me put a little bit of sambal here.
So we have our nasi champur here. Let's take a seat and give it a taste. So here we have our Babi Guling nasi champur special. So we have our nasi, our rice here, along with our nasi champur. And what it is, we have our delicious Babi Guling with the skin. We have fried pork blood, fried pork liver, as well as lawar, which is a special Balinese salad that has coconut green beans in it. So that's gonna be good. And of course, a little bit of that chili sambal. That's gonna nice big bite. Wow, just look at how crispy that skin is. And oh, look at all that bumbu that the Babi Guling was stuffed with. It just looks so flavorful. Okay, let's get some nasi. get some of that delicious lawar, a little bit of sambal, and of course, our Babi Guling meat. This looks incredible. Cheers. The skin completes the bite. Wow. Mmm. So amazingly tasty. The lawar adds a nice vegetable taste to this dish and very coconutty as well, actually. Mmm. Sambal is spicy, but not too spicy. But I think really what gives it so much flavor is that bumbu. So garlicky, gingery, lemongrassy, all the different spices that they mixed up and stuffed into the Babi Guling just really comes out. And again, that meat is ultra tender. Come take a look. Look how tender and juicy this meat is. Just look at that. Such a smoky flavor from the wood fire that it was cooked on. It actually just imparts such a nice flavor onto the meat. Oh my gosh, look at that. Try some of the fried pork liver. Mmm. Oh wow. Crunchy, a bit salty as well. Mmm, that's really good. You'd never know that was pork liver, to be honest. Mmm, it's like a chip. Wow. And some of the fried pork blood. So dark in color. Oh my gosh. Wow. It's almost like a fried seaweed consistency, like a seaweed consistency actually. Wow. Oh, that is so flavorful. A bit salty as well, but mmm. Never had pork blood this crispy or fried before. That's incredible. Oh my gosh, wow.
Look at this. Babi Guling hot plate.
Wow, thank you so much. Thank you so much, Putu. Oh my gosh.
Yes, a bestseller in our warung.
Bestseller in your warung. Oh, sizzling Babi Guling hot plate. Oh my gosh. Okay, look at this Babi Guling hot plate. What Putu, the owner, was telling us is one of their best sellers here at Babi Guling Odah Sanur. Look at that. So we have the water spinach there, got onions, as well as pieces of the Babi Guling skin and meat, as well as, of course, that delicious bumbu spices. Oh, this is sizzling hot on the hot plate. Incredible. All right. Mmm. Oh wow, having the skin cooked up like that actually makes it nice and soft and gelatinous actually. So it's a completely different flavor than the nasi campur with the crispy skin here. Mmm, but just so flavorful again with all that bumbu and the delicious greens. Oh, gotta have a bite with some rice too. Mmm. This has been a wonderful experience here at Babi Guling Odah Sanur, getting to see the entire cooking process, preparation of the Babi Guling, such a traditional Balinese dish and the most popular Balinese dish here. When you come to Bali, you have to try Babi Guling. And before we finish, let's have an ultimate Babi Guling bite with both the hot plate as well as the Babi Guling Nasi Champer special. Mmm. Amazing. Putu, thank you so much. Terimakasih, thank you so much. Enak, there's over 20 different Babi Guling special menu items here, so if you want to feed your Babi Guling craving, definitely pay this place a visit. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Chris.
Thank you so
thank
much.
You.
Oh, thank you so much, brother. Amazing.
laklaku 168 to try a traditional Balinese pancake. And you can see behind me just how traditional this is. He has got five fires going here with hot plates, and he's putting the pancakes into the top. And I can tell you, it is hot where I'm standing. So where he is right next to it is super hot. But this is a really traditional way of cooking them with the wood fire like this. I'm really excited to try this because I think it's going to be smoky, delicious, and coconutty. Here we have our little portion of laklak, and it comes with grated coconut and melted palm sugar. But just look at these little guys. Oh, okay. So they're super light and squishy. Look at that. And you can see the char on it from the hot plate that it was grilling in. And these are super green, as you can see, which is from the suji leaf extract. But they're just a very simple pancake made from rice flour, water, and coconut milk. So I think that's gonna make them super tasty. But again, just made in such a traditional way. Okay, I'm dying to try it. So cheers, here we go. Oh, still warm. It's super soft and almost gooey on the inside. Not like your typical pancake where it's kind of fluffy. It's like a different type of cooked. It's really quite an interesting texture. But the flavor, you can really taste that coconut milk. And I think it's because it's rice flour that it makes it kind of chewy and almost jello-y, actually. That's what I'm trying to think. It's almost jello-y. You can taste that coconut, and that's really tasty. But definitely need to get some of this grated coconut and melted palm sugar on top. Look at this coconut and melted palm sugar on top there. Hooey! Okay. That coconut and the melted palm sugar on top really make the difference. That's so tasty and flavorful. Adds a little sweetness to it, but the texture of that grated coconut on it as well, so good. And it does have a little bit of smokiness to it being cooked on the fire. A little bit crispy on the bottom, but not too much. Honestly, just a really nice light snack. And that. Yes. And I found it. It's so tasty.
Crispy. Yeah.
Very good.
Kacang. Ayam.
Yeah.
Bumbu?
Yeah, bumbu.
Wow.
We are here at this restaurant to try another legendary traditional Balinese dish. This is ayam betutu, which is a boiled chicken, but what makes it super special is what's on top. Now, this is bumbu betutu, which is a blend of spices, super spicy with chilies, ginger, galangal, garlic, turmeric, and as well, it's cooked in coconut oil, so it makes it super fragrant. We have a side of rice with the kacang, which is peanuts, as well as this jackfruit, which is nangka here in Indonesia, like a jackfruit soup. So that smells good too. Let's dig into this ayam betutu though. So we have some vegetables here as well. It looks like we have some water spinach as well as some fresh tomato and cucumber. But look at this chicken and the special boom boom betutu. Look at that. All right, let's grab a nice big piece of this chicken here. And this is a single portion, but you can just see, wow. Look at that nice white meat, and it just strips right away. So tender. Let's get a nice big bite of that betutu there. Get some peanuts on there as well. Oh. Okay, cheers. Mmm, oh wow, that is spicy. Holy moly. Chili pepper flavor with spices, but really garlicky and gingery as well, but it has got a kick to it. Chicken is so tender though. Mmm, what I love is the use of the kacang, the peanut. Mmm, it gives it an amazing crispy, crunchy flavor that adds to the spiciness of the chicken. And what makes it so spicy is that the chicken is actually boiled in the boom boom betutu sauce, so super, super spicy. I just can't get over though how just juicy this white meat chicken is. Usually white meat could be really dry, but because it's boiled, it's just actually really, really juicy still, stringy. Oh. Mmm. This is a really good dish. Let's try this Nangka jackfruit soup. Look at the jackfruit there. Such a huge piece. Wow. Mmm. Oh. Mmm. So flavorful. Oh. Nice and salty. It's not sweet at all either because of the jackfruit. The jackfruit almost actually tastes like meat. It is such a meaty fruit. That's a delicious complement to the spicy ayam betutu. Mmm, yeah. Let's make a nice big bite here with everything. Ultimate betutu bite. Get the tomato in there. Look at that with the boom boom betutu on there. And of course, our peanut kacang. Ultimate ayam betutu bite. Mmm. This is seriously spicy. Oh wow, super mega pettis. So, so spicy. Spicy, but delicious at the same time. Wow. Need some rice to cool this heat down. Mm. Mm-hmm. They sure know how to do their spicy here in Bali. Woo! My face is numb from this chicken.
Last stop of the day is for a very unique Balinese satay. Come on. Have a good satay griller here.
Satay chef Steph.
We are finishing off our Bali food tour with a pork and sambal feast. We've got two different kinds of pork, two different kinds of sambal. Here we have the satay babi plecing, which is a pork satay with a tomato-based spicy sambal. And then we have our babi goreng sambal mata. Now, sambal mata is very Balinese, super popular here, very fragrant with coconut, and it's a raw sambal. These both look incredible, but I'm gonna start with the satay plecing because, I don't know, this red spiciness, it's just getting me. Let's just do it. The Balinese plecing sauce is made with chili, garlic, onions, tomatoes, and a little bit of shrimp paste. Oh, look at that. Just so red. All those chilies, it's just completely stuck to all of them. Look at that. This is really a unique kind of satay because a lot of the satay here in Indonesia uses kacang peanuts. So the fact that this is tomato based is really different. All right, cheers. Super different, very tomatoey, and that spice is really starting to build. Those two pieces of meat, really tender. I'm gonna get a bite of this. This is the fat piece that was on the end of the stick, so. It almost has a crunchiness to it, which is quite different for pork, fat. That's really tasty and goes so well with the meat. The sambal they use is very unique with the tomato flavors, but it's also spicy. It's a little bit sour, it's savory. Just has so many different flavors going for it. The meat is so tender, juicy, flavorful. And the pork really goes with the tomato. That was some nice satay. Let's move on to the sambal mata. Sambal mata is a raw sambal made of lemongrass, shallots, kaffir lime leaves and juice, chilies, and most importantly, coconut oil. Just look at that. Oh my gosh, the flavor of coconut is so strong. That is incredibly tender, and that piece I had a nice bit of fat with it too. So just honestly kind of melted in my mouth. It's just so juicy, but I honestly just can't get over this coconut oil. It makes it taste so coconutty, and the contrast of the soft meat with the crunchiness of the shallots and the chili is honestly so nice. It's such a welcome contrast to textures. Oh my gosh, that oil just completely douses every piece of meat. You can see the pork is super juicy, nice and marbled with the fat. Just look at that juicy, juicy fat in there. Incredibly flavorful. What a unique Balinese dish. Sambal mata is something you have to have when you're in Bali. And honestly, I think it might be my favorite thing we've eaten today. This is insanely, insanely delicious. That is just so good. All in all, an incredible food tour around Bali, and you have to finish with an ultimate pork bite, because if there's something you need to eat in Bali as well, it's pork. If what we've shown you today says anything, that this island is full of some incredibly delicious pork, so. Cheers to Bali and it's Babi. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. We hope you've enjoyed our Bali food tour today. If you're interested in checking out any of the places that we visited today, then make sure you go to our description box below for all the location information. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like and make sure you subscribe to our channel to come on our next food adventure with us. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.